Hi, I'm Blake Bettner, the managing editor here at Worn and Wound.
And I'm Zach Kazan, the associate editor at Worn and Wound.
We are looking at a new watch from Aquastar today. This is the Aquastar 2.
The Aquastar Deepstar 2.
Aquastar Deepstar 2. Excuse me.
Yeah.
This is a dive watch from Aquastar. This is not their first release this year, though. You looked at another watch of theirs earlier. What was that one?
It was the Aquastar Deepstar Chronograph, which came out about a year ago now.
Yeah.
And that was a limited release. It was based on a historical Aquastar reference, a chronograph.
Right.
And it was the debut release from the revived Aquastar.
Sure.
Brand.
So, conversely, this is not based on a historic model.
Right. This is kind of inspired by the aesthetic of historic Aquastar, but it's not based on a specific reference from their from the original run.
Right. So it's got a lot of the same visual charm that one had, which is aplenty, I would say. So this kind of fixes one of the niggles that we had with the original chronograph, which wore a little large on the wrist. It's a bit thick. Lug to lug was a bit long. This is 37 millimeters.
Yeah, great size.
In diameter, and what did we call it? 47 in lug to lug. Yeah, and in thickness, it's just a little over 13, so perfectly manageable on the wrist. Now, this does carry the same visual identity of that chronograph.
Yeah,
that
very
means
much so.
It's got the large oversized register there at 9 o'clock. This time, this is just a running seconds hand over there. So this example has kind of this deep blue sunburst dial, but they made other versions of this, yeah?
There's a gray and there's a black dial as well.
I commented to you that this didn't read immediately as a dive watch to me, just because of some of the visual codes that we expect from a dive watch. A chunky bezel with an insert and chunky hour markers. This doesn't really have that. It's a very unique visual here with the, boy, what would you even call the shape of those cardinal markers?
So it has a strip of loom running through the center of two large applied markers. It kind of creates a trapezoidal shape. That's sort of the visual impression that it leaves me.
Yeah, it's very unique. And then the signage is kind of over to the right-hand side of the dial. So it's a little bit of asymmetry, mm-hmm. but it's balanced out by that large subdial. And then I see there's a couple of scales here on the bezel. So there's a lot going on. But it's a really fun watch.
It wears really well. It's so comfortable. It's just it's a really perfect size. I would say that I never had a chance to handle the chronograph when it was released. I wrote the article, but you had it here in the office, and the consensus was that it wore significantly larger than that 40 millimeter or 40 and a half millimeter size would indicate. This is 37 and wears, like, to me, kind of like a 39 or 40 millimeter watch, which is pretty perfect for me. But the shape of the case kind of naturally makes it wear a bit larger than the measurements would read. But they nailed the size on this one.
Yeah, I agree. It does wear a little larger, so don't be scared off if that 37 sounds a little small to you. The lug-to-lug is pretty typical of what I would expect from a 39-millimeter watch or something in that realm. So, and then certainly the thickness. But this is a watch that you could easily wear all day, every day. There's almost a formality to this watch, though.
Yeah, so there's polished elements on it. It's
the scripted typeface of the branding there. It's a really sharp watch. So this watch is released today. I believe it's on pre-sale right now. Is there a special price for the pre-sale of this one?
Yeah, I believe it's a little under $1,500 for the pre-sale and shoots up to just shy of $2,000 once the pre-sale ends. But they're fairly limited, so I don't even know if they'll last for the until the pre-sale is over. And they ship this month and throughout December.
And this comes from the same outfit that did the Synchron military.
Right.
That other Zach and I just talked about.
Yep.
Equally unique and a lot of charm in this one. I really like where they're going with this, and I really love the toned down size here. So yeah, if the chronograph was a little bit large, but you really like that visual identity, this would be a great option for you. We've got a lot more details on the site that you've written up for us, so be sure to check that out. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this, please like, share, and subscribe. Until next time.